But my guess is Mabel Katz, and her book is called Zero Frequency, The Easiest Way to Peace, Happiness, and Abundance. And there's some very, very cool things in here, guys, I've been reading about. And I know that you were much more well-known in Europe before you sort of came to the States.
Yes.
And I it's interesting because in relationship to your specialty, which I happen to know, believe it or not, a little bit about, and I thought it was really kind of interesting how... Yes, yes, exactly. How you came here, I'm going to have you explain to everybody what the technique is and how people can basically use it.
How much time do we have?
Right now we have a good half hour. How's that?
Okay, wonderful. Yes, yes.
Okay.
So I know how much to explain myself.
I may have you go closer to 7 o'clock, depending on the phone calls. I start getting a lot of phone calls right, and then, you know, I usually spend the last 10, 15 minutes giving messages. So that's where we are. But we certainly have for a good half hour, maybe a little longer. For
wonderful.
The rest of you, that we're calling, the number is 347-945-7785, 347-945-7785. Yes, I will be giving messages toward the end of the show like I always do. And but I want to get everybody sort of familiar with Mabel Katz as his work. But what I want you to share with your system is obviously my listening audience is they're wonderfully receptive, and I've had people from all walks of life, and I've actually had several people that I'm not sure if it's the same Hawaiian technique that you do, but that have been from Hawaii and have shared this technique, and it is actually quite a wonderful one. But what's nice, everybody, what I want you to know about Mabel is that the zero frequency works. I don't want to say it's like LNP, but it works sort of like where it changes your beliefs and memories and negative thoughts and things of all that sort. And what reason I, of course, besides the obvious of me knowing your work, I felt that this would be like a really key time to have you on the show because everybody's quite going through changes, I don't have to tell you, with COVID and all the other things that are going on. And I know if you live in Los Angeles, there's a lot going on there with a lot of the intense stuff. I'm giving my lot of prayers out there for everybody out at that place. And so there's clearly a lot of struggle, a lot of, you know, traumatic stuff going on. And I would think that this, your work, your ancient Hawaiian art of problem solving work would probably help a lot of people in their core of going through a lot of the things that they are going through. And I think, if I'm not correct from what I remember reading about you, is that you had moved, because I know you're from Argentina, I know you had moved to Los Angeles, and I know you were very successful at what you did, but somehow you felt something was missing in your life. And that's sort of how you came upon discovering this Hawaiian technique. So I'm sort of giving people some background for you. So now you can kind of go ahead and tell us how you got to where you are now, what the technique is about, and how it can be of really great help to people.
Yes, thank you for the opportunity, first of all. Thank you for waiting for me. Yes, I was born in Argentina. And I was a very successful accountant there, and also when I came to United States 37 years ago. So it was kind of crazy to let go of a career so stable and so profitable. But yes, I woke up and I realized that I was not looking for happiness in the right places. Yes, usually we look at it, you know, in the material things, in having a relationship, in having the family, in the titles, the university titles, I have two, but I was not happy. So again, I had everything that somebody thinks, you know, he needs to be happy, but I was not happy. And I was playing a lot of my kind of unsatisfaction, let's put it this way, with my oldest son. And one day he talked to me angry as I used to talk to him, and I saw myself, you know, you were like a mirror.
Yes, yes.
And I said, Mabel, you have to do something. And I started my search. I started my search about, you know, what anger was, you know, and I discovered Ho'oponopono, a very ancient Hawaiian art of problem solving that set me free, because I realized there is nobody out there doing anything to me, that when I change, everything changes, that everything has to do with memories, beliefs, judgments, things that we decided, you know, whatever is right or wrong, things that we bought. But again, we are not happy people. And
well, the thing is that
we're
raised a structural way, and you know, and I'm sure, particularly if I know the Hispanic culture, whether it is Hispanic, you know, whether it is from Argentina or from Mexico, where I've also have worked a lot, is that, you know, family is number one, and, you know, providing for your family is, of course, extremely important, and that's supposed to give you all the, you know, things that make you happy in your life. And in one course does not work for everybody, you know?
Exactly, exactly. So, you know, the first time I felt free for my first time in my life was when I realized through Ho'oponopono that I was 100% responsible, that I was creating my life. And depending on my own decisions, and only when I change, everything changed. So I said, hey, if I created it, I can change it. Because usually we are waiting for something out there to change, or we are trying to change people, or we think we depend on things. Exactly. Or depending on things or things, you know, to make you happy. So to be honest with you, it was for the first time I was happy to find out I was 100% responsible, that everything is like a movie, you know, that the projector is in you. So if you don't like the movie, you have to change. It's not about out there.
Exactly. Well, like I said, you know, we you know, and it's not just all, you know, it's not just all cultures, but in general, again, you know, we see things from the external, and that's why when things happen that are traumatizing, which of course, you know, so many people right now are experiencing so many external external, you know, fears, and they're all true. I mean, there's fires in California, which I know are awful, and there's COVID, which has gotten people, you know, we know we're up to 200,000 people. And when you keep looking at all of those things, and you dwell on all of those things and all the other things that go on with the world in terms of, you know, politics and government and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, you have to, you're right, you have to be conscientious to say, I can't watch this anymore, or I'm responsible for me not being pulled into all of that. And
exactly.
So,
let me tell you something that I tell my people, you know. I said, everybody is living their own quarantine, their own pandemic right now, because this is an opportunity for us to really look at ourselves. Yes? So this is an opportunity for us to take responsibility. There are not two persons right now that are going through the same experience with this. And for example, I mean, something that I consider kind of a miracle. First of all, I was able to go on vacation. I mean, to come to Mexico on vacations with my family, like we usually do every year for my birthday in August. And we consider it a miracle, but we were able to do it. And then right now I am in Mexico, and I just presented a two-day seminar for almost 300 people. So how do you create that in your life? How do you open that possibility? You have to be open, because if you close yourself to the fear, if you buy into the fear and this and that, that's what you are going to attract in your life. But if you trust, if you let go, if you know that everything that happens is perfect, even if it doesn't look like, then you attract a completely different reality. And we are all creating our own reality right now.
Yes,
so
we are.
If you are willing to take 100% responsibility, yes.
You're absolutely right. I want you to hold that thought, Mabel. And the number to call in for everybody is 374-347-945-7785. We have a few people on side for sessions for me at the end. If you hold on, you may have a good shot. I'm going to try to take probably the first three callers. But again, the number to call is 347-945-7785. And we'll be right back. We're going to take a quick break with my guest, Mabel Katz. And I know that she's doing some quite wonderful things, and we're going to listen to some of the other things that she has to say about this taking responsibility and learning to really listen to yourself. Absolutely. And we'll be right back in a moment. Welcome back. This is Suzane Northrop, and my special guest is Mabel Katz, and she's speaking actually from Mexico, which, by the way, you may not know this, but that happens to be one of my very favorite places to work. And I haven't been there in several years, but when I was there, I was incredibly – I couldn't believe how well-received it was. I worked more than – I think I worked more on, like, 10 days there than I think I did in like 3 months of book tour in the seats in the States, and I worked every day in the States. It was unbelievable. They couldn't get enough from me, so I have to say I was so welcomed graciously. And I don't speak the language, a little bit here and there, but they took care of me so gratefully. So I could see why when you are doing what you're doing with that culture, they just sort of like eat it up. And it's true. I remember people they drove I know many hours to come and see me speak, and I thought it was just really kind of amazing because, as you well know, Dia de Muertos is the holiest day of the year there. And so their connection with loved ones that have crossed over is huge in that culture. So, like I said, they couldn't have welcomed me enough. So I could really see why you would pull in that kind of an audience, because they're just so receptive. And I would say that, you know, and I'm very happy that you're working a lot with Hispanic culture in Los Angeles as well, because I've also kind of been there. And sometimes they're a forgotten culture in terms of people not aware of how spiritual the culture really is. So I could see why you would love being there, I guess.
Yes, yes. No, I love the Mexican people also receive me, you know, they are very kind and very lovely and very loving. And this was kind of a miracle, you know, that we were able to present something in these times, that they would allow us to put so many people in a room, you know. It was really amazing.
Yes.
We still kept, you know, social distancing, and we had to, you know, some protocols and things like that, but they allow us to do it, and that was kind of a miracle. The same thing of being with the family.
You're dealing with
yes.
people that take responsibility, see, and if you take responsibility that, you know, you are connected and hurting other people, then you take it upon, that's really what you're talking about here also. You're talking about being responsible.
You are creating your own reality. That's why some people
yes.
have work right now and some people are out of work. Because, I mean, if you bought into the fear and everything, the universe always reflects to you back what is inside of you. So if you want to change something, to change, you have to change. That's the thing that we need to realize. And what I talk about zero frequency is exactly how you can be at the right time with the right people at the right place. But you have to allow it. You have to be like the river, you know, that knows it's going to be rocks, it's going to be things, but you go around them. You know, it's not like you get stuck or paralyzed when things happen, because life is about problems, you know, because we learn from problems. You know, we grow
that's
from
right.
problems,
now,
and that's why we are here.
Life doesn't come with a manual, right?
Oh, no.
It doesn't
we
come with
wish,
a manual.
Yes. Yeah, exactly. That
no,
would
we
be
would
the idea,
because,
to come with a manual.
Right. Well, that's the whole plan. The whole plan is it doesn't come with a manual. The plan is that you're given the tools. You know, and there's a lot of those tools from the day you choose to come in, the family you choose to come in, and all that. Those are basically the graph, and it's kind of what you do with it.
Yes. Well, you know, I wrote this. I finished this book 1 year ago, but this time the book had a time. God had a plan, you know, for this book, and it was written for these times. I talk about
yes.
in the book, but this I written this a long time ago. But I'm talking about a pandemic of love and peace, and I'm talking about that love heals, and I'm talking about changing humanity, and I'm talking about homeschooling in the book, in a book that I wrote years ago. It just been published, but you know, God had a plan, because this was this is so timely. This is about how to relax when you have a problem instead of worrying, you know, or how you have to breathe, you know, you have to let go, because the worst thing we can do when we have a problem is think or worry. And that's what we are so used to. We think that's natural, or that's what you have to do, or that's the right thing to do. But it doesn't work.
No, that's why I actually, you know, I've been doing a lot of teaching through this, and I started, my first webinar was, you know, the intuitive soul during a crisis, and that's, it's like that's, the soul knows that we were all supposed to be here at this time for this reason, period. That's
exactly.
Not an accident. We chose
to be here. It's an opportunity.
Yes. So it's like anything else. It's like you either see the glass half full or half empty, or you take the gifts that you have, you make them work with you, or you don't. And that's, it's interesting, right before, because it took you a while to get on, I was mentioning how that recently, this last, I mean, I've had it over the several over the years of my work, but the last 6 months I have had gotten a lot of, you know, emails and phone calls from people that have, you know, they've met this person that's supposed to know about angels, and they met this person that's supposed to know about this and that, and some of them have gotten themselves in trouble in terms of paying money, expecting this to go away, and they're not going to go away, and it's looking for the external instead of looking for somebody that can help them help themselves, exactly what we're talking about here.
Exactly.
And so
We were laughing because actually some people were saying that when they decided to come to the seminar, he says, oh, you are going with your cult. You know, some people confuse, you know, religion even with spirituality. It has nothing to do with
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely.
Yes, spirituality is about, actually, the power is in you. You can change it, yes? Spirituality brings peace. It makes us family. It doesn't divide us. Yes, so
right.
Some people are so close-minded that they don't understand that in the spirituality is where they are going to find all the answers and all the solutions they are looking for.
Because spirituality is a direct connection to God, and you don't need
exactly.
In between to have a deck. If you may choose to practice religion in a certain way for whatever reason, that may,
sure.
You know, you may choose to do
sure.
That, but your connection with God is your connection with job. That's your deal. Across the
exactly.
Board, that's your deal.
I had presented in many countries in the world, and it happened to me that I also presented in Israel, and I had religious people coming to my seminars, and some religious Jewish women came to me in one of the breaks and said, you know, Mabel, we are religious, but today you gave us an amazing lesson about faith. Because being religious is not that you actually believe. You might be religious for the wrong reasons. But spirituality doesn't go against any religion. And if you find peace in your religion, that's what you have to keep doing. Whatever brings you peace, whatever, you know, works in your life, that's what you have to do.
That's correct. That's absolutely correct. And like I
so
say,
following your heart. You have to follow your heart, and you need to trust. Trusting right now is the most important thing. If you want
yes,
to go
right
through
now,
everything
that
we are going through.
Yes, that you must really, really trust, and that you're going to be okay. And listen, it's you don't just, you know, wave a wand and say, oh, this is not going to happen. You take responsibility. That's part of listening
yes.
To yourself. You take responsibility for your actions. And it's the same thing. It's you see a car racing down the road. Well, you don't run across the street thinking that you're not going to get hit by it.
Yeah. Like right now.
Cars racing down the street.
Yeah.
You go to the light.
Okay. So
stop.
Right now, exactly. No, I mean you're not going to defy God. Yes. But the thing right now, you need to take care of yourself. You do have to take care of your immune system and things like
yep.
That. There is a virus. But, I mean, if you buy into the fear, I mean, you are more even susceptible, yes, to contract
yes.
The virus. You have to
yes.
Raise your vibration. You have to raise your frequency. And you definitely have to let go and trust. And knowing that you are not alone and that if you are given permission, you will be protected and you will be guided. And there is nothing you need to worry about.
I just want to mention to everybody really quickly here again, the book is called Zero Frequency, The Easiest Way to Peace, Happiness, and Abundance. And Mabel Katz, I think she goes by Mabel, and Katz
yes.
Is her last name, K-A-T-Z. And I am assuming many people, I know that this is on Amazon. I know it's in English, guys, and I know it's in Spanish.
Yes.
And so as my books are in English and in Spanish, so we share that commonality. And obviously you are doing – so is that the best way to get to your website, Mabel?
Yes, well, I actually would like to invite your audience, because if they go to zerofrequency.com/book, they also, when they submit the receipt or the order number from Amazon, when they get the book, they can get $100 in digital resources. You know, my very first Zero Frequency training that I did in Los Angeles with my teacher, Dr. Ijaliakala Julen, and then another training that we did in Los Angeles with Don Miguel Ruiz and Dizzy Cordova, Gabriel Nosovich, Gary Quinn, is wonderful training. So they can get that as a complement and or bonuses. And also the book comes with 10 videos where I kind of accompany people, you know. So again, and it's definitely is available in English and Spanish, both in Amazon.
Okay, so you go to Amazon.com and you order Zero Frequency, The Easiest Way to
by
Peace,
Mabel Katz.
Happiness, Abundance, by
yes.
Mabel Katz, and her name is spelled M-A-B-E-L, guys, last name K-A-T-Z, and you can get all the offerings that she's sort of showing you on the Amazon
yes.
books. So
Zerofrequency.com, zerofrequency.com/book.
Okay, zerofrequency.com/book. So, you got all of that. So, we're gonna take a quick break, and then I'm gonna try to take some calls. So, before we let you go here, Mabel,
yes.
you've said some wonderful, wonderful things to everybody, and if you had some parting words other than the ones you've already sort of shared with us in terms of.
Yes.
The wonderness of it really, and it's really true, because if there's no other time, I always tell people, I said, you know, when you're going through traumas in your life, you know, you may be a real good astrology buff and be really good in astrology, or you may be really good with your tarot cards, or you may, but you when you're during that time, that's the time you really need to be able to tune in and listen to yourself, because you may not have access to those external things, but you always have access to internal things. And that's exactly
yes.
what you're talking about. Yeah, but I understand
exactly.
completely. And
one of the things that, for me, I'll tell you the most important things, and I go. You don't depend on anybody or anything outside yourself to change your life. You have everything inside.
That's,
and the other thing that for me is very important is be yourself. There to be yourself. Don't care what other people think. You know, just be
yes.
yourself. Be happy. Love yourself. Trust yourself. You know, for me, that's the key. And especially for young people.
Yes.
Especially for young people. They don't have to waste time like we did.
Well, the thing is that, you know, they got to go through their path like we went through our path, and everybody, you know, has to sort of like go through it. But I think really a lot of young people, to be honest with you, these days are very challenged with what's going on in the world. So I think that anything that they can take in, and I know that I have a lot of young people that tune into my show, which I'm always pleased about, is that it's always going to help us along the way. So you've been a wonderful
okay.
guest.
Thank you.
Anybody who missed
Thank
the show
you.
Or wanted to miss the first part of the show, of course, you can always go to blogtalkradio.com, click on Suzane Northrop, and you can certainly listen to the show again and get any information that you need on Mabel Katz. And the thing is, it's zerofrequency.com/book. So for the rest of you guys that have called in, stay on the line. We're going to try to get to as many readings as we can. Thank you again, my dear. You've been a wonderful guest.
Thank you so much, Suzanne. I'm sorry about I was late, but
That's
I'm glad
okay.
we were able
you're,
to do it. Thank you.
You're good. You're good. We'll be in touch.